News. First, with breaking news.
Because the fundamental thing that keeps the country going, progressing, and surviving, the root of it is security and welfare of the citizens. That's why our constitution clearly states that the purpose of government is security and welfare of the citizens. You know, these two key things are now under
threat in Nigeria. We are not talking about welfare anymore, but even the security is seriously a threat. At the beginning, it started like Jojo, starting from small stealing and all that. That accumulated into armed robbery. In the early 70s in this country, you hardly hear of armed robbery. I remember when we were in secondary school, one of the first armed robbers that was executed at the beach in Lagos was Oyunisi. Oyunisi. Yes. They call him Robert Kim. Over 30,000 people gathered at the beach to watch his execution with his colleagues. Then the next one that was famous was that of Anini. But other than that, before today, armed robbery is a small crime in Nigeria now. You see people, banditry, kidnapping, and of course the insurgency that has bedeviled the Northeast for the past 11 years now. To the extent that in Maiduguri now, once it's 5 o'clock, you cannot go in or come out of Maiduguri from all angles. By 10 o'clock, Maiduguri is shut down. You can't go anywhere. Curfew starts from 10 o'clock. In fact, this is even an improved situation. We hear of kidnapping, banditry, headsmen, and all sorts of crime these days. The nation is at the brink of collapse. The unfortunate thing is that Nigerians from top to bottom still trivialize, tribalize, or give the situation religious correlation. And we are now in this sorry state. We're not talking about unemployment, the number of youths that we have out there on the streets, the number of mothers, I mean orphans that we have. We're not talking about the poor people that cannot afford even a single meal in a day. We're not talking about schools that have collapsed. We're not talking about our hospitals that you can no longer afford to even take care of yourself. You are not talking about a situation where even if you have the resources, you go to the chemist and the man will sell you a fake drug. He collects your money just to sell you expired drug or fake drugs. So the situation is terrible. And wherever there is a forum like this, I think there is the need for us to talk and provide solutions. I, as a legislator with experience of getting to 20 years now, I must confess to you that I'm confused. I'm truly confused. The problem in this country is so much today that the solution to it is only with us. Unfortunately, Nigeria is one of the religious countries. So, most of all now resort to God. We say, let's pray. Let us pray. May God help us. God will help us. Oh God should help us. And you see the pastors are thriving, the imams are thriving. Tomorrow now, most of you will flock to church. Go there and raise up your hand and start shouting to God. Well, it's good, I say, I'm a Muslim, a dedicated one. But I believe that God will only answer your prayers if you genuinely have confessed your sins, and you truly believe in God, and you truly do your own bit. If you do your own bit rightly, then God will help you. But if you just sit down there, perpetuate criminality, tribalism, other sentiments, and then you expect God will solve your problem, then you are wasting your time. Having said that, let me throw this thing back to you.
First, with breaking